Hey guys, this is Mike Tarallo with Qlik, and in this video, I'm going to walk you through some of the sharing and co-development and collaboration and content management options that are available with the cloud-based editions of Qlik Sense. Now, if you recall, I created a two-part product tour on Qlik Sense cloud-based editions, which include Qlik Sense Enterprise on Kubernetes and Qlik Sense Enterprise on Qlik Cloud Services. And also some pieces applied to Qlik Sense Business. So in this particular video, I'm going to continue that tour. Think of it as a bonus video. It's going to be a little bit longer, but it's basically going to focus on some of the options involving content management around spaces and how they look with different accounts. So you can see how it works with different permissions and roles. So to get started, I have three accounts that have already been set up. I have Mike 1, Mike 2, and Mike 3. And we'll use different browser sessions to see the results of each. So the first one I'm logging in with is Mike 1. Now, Mike 1 is a tenant admin, so I have the ability to go into the management console for my particular environment. One other thing to point out is I'm going to take this from the standpoint of Qlik Sense Enterprise on Kubernetes or Qlik Cloud Services, but understand Qlik Sense Business has also some management options. However, it is limited to just using shared spaces, and you have up to 5 shared spaces that you can manage and organize. With Qlik Sense Enterprise on Kubernetes and Qlik Cloud Services, you have unlimited shared spaces, as well as a concept of something called managed spaces. Okay, so we'll get into a little bit more detail as I demonstrate that, and we'll cover those topics. So I'm going to log in as Mike 1. And keep in mind, I'm using the Qlik Sense Enterprise on Qlik Cloud Services for this example here. And being I am a tenant admin, if I go to my profile menu, you can see I have a link for administration. Now I'm going to go into this just to show you the management console and just to show you the three accounts that I have set up. And you can see Mike 1, Mike 2, and Mike 3. And you can see Mike 1 is a tenant admin. And if I wanted to assign a tenant admin to another account, I can do so. Now, if we go to license and user allocation, and I go to assigned users, you can see that Mike 3 is listed as an analyzer license, meaning he can consume or view only. And then Mike 1 and 2 are also listed, but they are professional licenses. They can consume and create apps. Understand this concept does not exist within Qlik Sense Business. Pretty much technically everyone is like a professional license, but you're able to control roles and permissions through the interface, and you're going to see some of that. Okay, so we have that established. So what we're going to do now is we're just going to go back to the main hub, and we're going to share some content. So the first thing I'm going to do is make my sheet available within my app. So in the product tour, I created a very simple app, and we talked about some of the capabilities, the features, and functionality within the Qlik Sense for cloud-based editions. But one thing I did do was make a sheet public so I could share it with an individual, but now we're going to talk about utilizing the spaces feature. So to reiterate, when you go into an app and you create your sheets and your visualizations, they'll be set up as My Sheets. Okay, this is from the standpoint of somebody with create capability, somebody who can create an app. So I have a sheet already created here, but it's not publicly available. So in other words, if you shared this, it would have no sheets available for the person to use. So a step you must perform is right-click on the sheet and choose Make Public. So in other words, you can keep some sheets as private for yourself, and then you can also make sheets available for consumption. And very simply, if you just want to make it private again, you just right-click on the public sheet and select Make Private. Okay, so that's the first step that you need to do in any app that you're going to be sharing or co-developing with, etc. Okay. So now we're going to go back into the hub. So we're dealing with the Sales Dashboard 2 app. We've made the sheet public. Now, if you click the little ellipsis button in the corner and then click Edit, you have the option of moving the app into a different space. Or when you create an app, you can create an app within a particular space. So we're going to now talk about shared spaces. So if I go to the Explore menu, you can see there's a little context menu here, and it shows me that I'm looking at apps that exist in all the spaces that I have access to. In this case, they're either shared or managed spaces. If this was Qlik Sense Business, it would just be shared spaces. And then I also have my personal work area. If I wanted to add a space, I can just click this link. Now, providing I have access to do so, this option will be available. Keep in mind, a tenant admin can also create spaces from the management console. So here we will click add space, and we're just going to give it a name. And I'll call it Mike Shared Space. And you can see there's two options for type, shared or manage. The first one is going to be shared. To keep things simple, a shared space is where you can create apps and where you can store and organize and secure your apps, okay, and co-develop. So think of shared space and creation capabilities for creating apps. That's where you store, organize, and secure, as well as create your apps. A managed space is for consumption only. So you can publish a app that you create in your personal content or in a shared space, for example, to a managed space, and then assign users and roles to that space. And that is for consumption only. Now, there is the ability to create data stories as well as your own personal sheets from those approved based apps. But understand, you do not create any apps within a managed space. So we'll create the shared space. And immediately, we're asked to invite members. So I'm the owner. So now we're going to add, say, Mike 2. And Mike 2, at this point, you can see he can view, is an admin, or can edit. So viewing basically means Mike 2 can look at the app's content. Is admin, this means that Mike 2 can also manage members and settings of the space. And can edit, this means Mike 2 can actually go into the app and create his own sheets, as well as create
apps within that space.
So if we put can edit and click add and click close, okay, just to give you a quick example, we're going to switch over to a new session, and I'm going to use the incognito capability of Chrome. Go to the same environment, and this time we're going to log in with Mike 2. Now, Mike 2 is a professional license within Enterprise for Kubernetes or Qlik Cloud Services, and you'll see there is the create button. So if I created a brand new app, you can see that I can choose Mike's shared space, okay, because I have edit access as well. So I can create directly within that space, or if I created something within a personal space, I'll just create app one in personal just so you can see some content. If I wanted to, I can click edit and I could switch it over to the shared space as well. Okay, so just a quick example of what the edit does. Now, if you're using this technique within incognito, you can click on this button right here and click exit incognito. That way it'll clear the session. So if you're switching users, you can see the differences. Okay, so back to Mike 1, who is the tenant admin. Click home. There's our app. I'm going to click on edit. Now, don't get confused with this edit. It's not editing the app. It's editing the properties of the app, such as the name, the space, the description, and the tags. In this case here, we're going to put it in Mike's shared space and click save. Now, when we go to explore, we're directly in Mike's shared space, or I can navigate it from the Find Spaces search box. So now, if I want to go into the app, I see the sheet, I can start adding more sheets. Now, the same thing goes for Mike 2. We go back and we're going to launch the incognito window. Log back in as Mike 2. Explore Mike's shared space. Click on the app. And now I can go and I can create my own sheets. This is just a very simple example of a visualization. I'm not going to go into too much detail here. And then we go back to the app overview. Now, Mike 2 could say, hey, I contributed to this. I want to make my visualization and my sheet public. So now Mike 2 contributed or co-developed with Mike 1. Okay, so let's talk about managed spaces next. And keeping in mind that managed spaces is an example of enterprise governance that is only available with Qlik Sense Enterprise cloud-based editions. So to do this, let's go back to our main interface where mic one is logged in as the tenant admin. And let's navigate to the shared space that we created earlier. And there's the app that we were working on. And there's the app that also mic two was able to contribute to. Now, once again, just going up to the context menu, you'll notice there's a link for add a space. This time we're going to create one called mics manage space. And this time check the radio button for managed and then click create. And keeping in mind, this can also be done through the console, as I mentioned earlier. Okay, now we're going to add roles or permissions to a particular user. So we're going to have mic two. And you can see you can have multiple roles or permissions for that particular space. Don't so much think of it as applying these permissions to the user. It's more of applying these permissions to the space that that user is going to have access to and can perform a number of different tasks. So Mike 2 can view, he can contribute, meaning that if you have a published app, you still can create your own self-service type of analytics through your own sheets and then share those with other community members through this published app. Manage, in other words, they can manage members and edit details of the managed space and then publish, meaning that if you have an app in another space, you can then publish to this managed space from that other area that you might be in. So we're going to give Mike the ability to pretty much contribute, manage, publish pretty much everything, and then click add. And then also, if you remember, we have Mike 3. And for Mike 3, we're just going to say they can just view and then click close. Okay, so now as mic one tenant admin, we're going to go back into the shared space. And if we click the ellipsis button here in the corner, you'll notice there's now an option for publish. Now, when you publish this, it takes this app and makes it available in the managed space. But also at the same time, you still can edit and work and co-develop on this app while you're in the shared space. One of the benefits of having shared spaces and managed spaces. So we click publish. Select Mike's managed space. And now it is available in there. But at the same time, this is completely unaffected now in the sense that I could still continue to develop on this if I needed to. So now let's switch back to the Mike 2 session. Let's navigate to the hub. Keeping in mind, Mike 2 was just added to that space a moment ago. And you'll see it now has popped up. And there's the app that Mike 2 can view. But you'll notice he has the ability to also schedule or reload the data here to get the freshest data. Clicking edit is not really editing the app. It's editing the details of the app, such as the name, adding tags, and the description. Now, Mike 2 is going to go into this app. Now, remember, as Mike 2, Mike 2 also has the ability to contribute. So what that means is he can create his own sheets based off of the approved public sheets. And then he could use the capabilities of the master items that were created, as well as any master visualizations that have been created to create their own analytics. And then at the same time, he can publish this into a section known as the community. So now when we go back to the app overview, anybody who has access to this app in the space will see other sheets that Mike 2 made available for them to review. Okay, so we're going to do that right now. We're going to exit the incognito session, start a new one. And this time we're going to log in as Mike 3. And you can see in the all spaces, there it is, but let's just navigate and you can see now it's available. Now you can see Mike 3 doesn't have any other access other than the details. And then if Mike 3 goes into this, you can see it has the community sheet that Mike 2 published that can be viewed, but notice that Mike 3 doesn't have contribute rights, so he cannot create his own sheet, so there's no plus symbol here. And then just like any other Qlik Sense app and visualizations, they can now continue to just analyze the data as they were previously. Okay, so once again, going back to the app overview or going back to the hub as mic 3 in the managed space. Also, you can see the members across the top. Exit incognito. Let's go back in, create a new incognito, and go back in as mic 2. And the reason I'm doing this is because I want to also bring up another point. If I go into the managed space as mic 2, we made him a admin, so you can see he can manage the members, the roles, remove individuals, or have access to the settings of the space. Okay, so that is the end of this video. I appreciate you hanging around until the end. And as you have seen, what I demonstrated is not difficult, but it does have a lot of moving pieces. So hopefully the time that I spent on this will clarify any of your questions. And of course, if you have more, just post them in the comments below where this video is available, either on YouTube or the Qlik community. Thanks for your time, guys. I hope to see you on the next video. Take care.